Hello to all. Lisbon has seven hills and one of them attracts more people than the others. Small stroll around Lisbon Castle in the districts of Alfama, Demuraria and Graça. On the menu, steep stairs, winding lanes, street art galore, some bars, points of view, some of the most important churches in Lisbon and plenty of other things. The stroll could start a bit like a fairy tale. Once upon a time, there was a castle. Lisbon has a long history. She had, amongst others, the Phoenicians, the Romans, the Visigoths, then the Moors from North Africa. Moors because more Berber than Arab. Around the castle, a kasbah, the Arabic word for fortress. A big mosque and some smaller ones. A palace for the governor, craftspeople, merchants, narrow lanes with no windows to the outside and hardly any communal space. An Arab city whose spirit and some vestige still remain. Let's start by La Muraria. Muraria because it was the Moorish ghetto. Stuck there after the crusader reclaimed the city in 1147, the poor district in the shadow of the castle saw the birth of Fado and its sad melodies. Nowadays, the entire world lives there. Africans, Asians, and then all the others where they come from. The district is known for its poverty, for the delinquency issues linked to drugs, and also for its street art. Lisbon is one of the capital cities of street art in Europe. You just have to go for a stroll and you will find art pieces in different forms. Photo, graffiti, murals, stencil, structures. Lisbon's street art tour organizes walks if you don't trust in your ability to get lost. Despite the bad reputation, the district is changing. Real estate promoters are starting to buy and renovate buildings. And the same fate that met Alfama seems to be sealed. Lose yourself, but don't forget to go up. We will join Graça and its incredible point of view. A small square, often invaded, its cafe and terrace in the shade. The view on the castle, the red bridge in the background and the old city roofs. If you haven't fallen in love with the city yet, it won't be long before you do. We climb down towards Alfama. We pass by St. Vincent of Fora Monastery with its stern facade. A wonder, a Renaissance church with Baroque elements like a superb canopy, a cluster surrounded by azulejos, a tanker at the bottom. The King's Mausoleum and a terrace on the roof. At the bottom, in God's shadow, the Thieves Market. There's a flea market there on Tuesday and Saturdays, a mythic point for bargain hunters, collectors, onlookers, those who believe in luck and rare objects, and cheap. We pass by the Pantheon, a bright Baroque church, which would fit in Rome. Then we go down, then up, and we get lost. We don't look for anything, or maybe only Santo Estevao Gazebo. More roofs and always jagged facade, and the sea. I mean the Taj, with the sea at the end. Blue and colors, the sun and the shade, breeze and young people puffing on the joint. Then we go back to get lost. Lanes, stairs, the Arab city. We buy a glass of cherry liquor from the local grandmothers and we carry on. We avoid groups, read the cats, we thank the children for the noisy zest for life. Alfama changes from one year to another. The formerly lively and popular district is changing into a dorm for tourists. The houses are beautiful and renovated, the lanes are clean, but some of the romantic charm has disappeared with the older people, the more modest ones, and the crumbling walls. Such is life. In Alfama, the daily joy and daily casualness of the locals coexist with the highest concentration of bars and restaurants to listen to Fado. The calm of the lanes and solitudes on one side, the procession of agitated visitors, straight from planes or boats, like the Vikings before them on the other side. A bittersweet district. Join Muraro das Portas do Sol for a last glance on the districts. So, do you like the city now? You can join the castle if you like medieval military architecture, or if you wish to look at Lisbon from another angle. If not, the castle is rather empty and the visit disappointing. You can have a drink at Café da Garagem, discreet, elegant and full of light. Then look at the sunshine before it sets down on the facade of Graça. You can also go down to the lower town of Baixa along the yellow tram number 28 and join the Sé. La Sé is the cathedral, the most important religious building in Lisbon. She was built on a great mosque, itself built on a Visigoth church that was built on a Roman forum. And we could go on like that for ages. We just wait for the go ahead from the archaeologist and the result on the excavation in the cloister. Roman, Gothic and Baroque art mingle here. And you will see impressive sculptures and beautiful stained glass windows and feel the magic sobriety of medieval architecture. That's how our visit around the castle comes to an end. May it live happily ever after. You will find more info about Lisbon in description. Let us know if you like the stroll by leaving a comment. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to follow and support us and discover more city in an original way. Be curious and enjoy the stroll.